It's hard to balance out the two, you know what I mean? When you're a fighter, it's kind of a lifestyle, and, you know, my wife is the kind of wife that kind of needs to actually be at home with my kids and tell them I should be in the gym, giving my kids the best picture I can give them by fighting. And, it's hard to kind of do that with somebody that really kind of don't understand boxing.
What do you weigh now?
I won like 85 right now.
Okay, so
I'm not too bad, yeah. I was like 200 and some pounds, though. But I think that's the beauty of boxing. You had all the odds stacked against you, and, you know, you could come out a winner. And so, you know, may the best man win.
So how about you staying in the gym, staying fit?
Yeah. I actually just got done with a workout right now at the hotel where the strength and conditioning have been working with me, Fat Far, Mario, work with a lot of guys in Oakland. You know, I just got out the gym now, and I'm back here again for the open workout.
Excellent. We look forward to seeing you step back in the ring.
Thank you. Gracias. Por la todo gente. What's up, baby? What's up,
man? It's been a long time, man.
With my diesel leather.
You still want to talk about that?
What's up, baby?
How you feel, Peter?
What's up? You good? How you feeling? You ready for it?
I'm ready.
What's up, Mr. Pitt? What's up, baby?
So, Peter, they just asked you, who do you favor most in the Golovkin versus Jacobs? Your name's been tossed in the hat in the past with fighting Golovkin. You're familiar with Jacobs. Who do you have winning the fight, and can you break it down for us?
Well, you know, right now, I think Geneda Golovkin has all the hype around him. So people will only say that he has all the hype, that Danny has a lot to prove. But,
right.
You know, this is a middleweight fight with two guys that got explosive hands. And, you know, anything can happen in this type of fight, you know, depending who has the best game plan. So, you know, but like I said, Geneda Golovkin has all the hype around him right now, and, you know, hopefully that Danny can stay focused with the odds stacked against him, crash him down.
Now, is it safe to say that Daniel Jacobs is the toughest test in Gennady Golovkin's career, vice versa as well, to Jacobs?
Yes, at this level, yes it is, I believe so, yes. And I think for Danny as well, yes, it's the toughest challenge for him as well.
We expect you back in the ring, and we're going to be back at 168.
Yeah, we looking at fighting at a catch weight right now, so we haven't made a super decision, but I know I've been off for a year, damn near and a half right now, so we looking to make sure that we just stay focused and stay in the gym all the time. So right now, I'm going to be fighting at catch weight when I do come back. We're looking at a time in April. Hopefully, that's the time that come around, and most people in the fans can be excited to see me come back.
Any specific names at 168? Anybody you'd like to call out?
Well, you know, I think the calling out game is for those guys that feel like they need that. I got the name right now. The hype is always going to be around me, just what kind of fighter I am. I'm very explosive, and I'm going to make a fight when I step in there. So I think all around, you know, guys, I lead the calling out for the guys that need to fight.
Can you give us a brief prediction on Garcia versus Thurman?
But this is another explosive fight, you know. Garcia has been somebody they always say he was a cherry picker, and I don't think that's the case. He fought some top quality guys and everything, and this is the fight that people need to come out and watch and support, because, you know, this is a top welterweight fight right here, 147, two of the best, squaring off at two of the best. How dare do people say that PBC don't put on good fights? You know, this is a top quality fight right now, and if you can say no to that, then I must call you a liar. But no, I'm happy to be in attendance. You know, both guys are my friends, so I won't be choosing a winner, but I will say, may the best man win.
And my last statement here, a lot of fight fans are hurting for Kid Chocolate. We need you back. Good luck to you, my man.
Thank you, man. God bless y'all. Y'all see me back soon.
Kid Chocolate, my man. Catch us up on everything Kid Chocolate for the ES News demographic, man. ES News hasn't had no Kid Chocolate in a while, man. I know you got a new baby girl.
Yes. Well, you know, I've been chilling. I just had a new baby girl December 13th. You know what I mean? It's like a blessing. I always wanted a little girl. Had a little boy first, so I guess you got a big bro.
Got a big bro.
And so, you know, it's like a lot of family changes for me. You know, you'll realize that your immediate family become your kids and your wife and stuff. You know what I mean? I had to separate myself. I do a lot for my own family, my mom, my dad and my brothers.
I'll probably know it.
My dad is definitely good. I just went to Michigan and just seen him now. You know, he's dying to be in my arms right now, but I said, Papi, cuidado. You're coming to IE, Michigan. You know, you're IE, New York. You know what I'm saying? My life is on the road. You probably should be in one place at a time. When I get to a place where I'm able to be in one place, you come and visit me. My wife loves him. My kids love him. So, you know, we're always happy to have him around us.
Trainer, I saw you. You've been ecstatic. You've been posting pics. Everybody's in the gym. Birdo, Ward. How's that experience been for you?
Man, you know, when you had a, when you're in the gym where you got top guys there, and it's like that. That energy is so powerful, man. You know, it's just so it's a lot of motivation there. So for me, it's just like I got the support right there in the gym that I'm always going to need. You know, Virgil Hunter with that kind of guidance and that coaching and that teaching. You know, I'm only going to go back to the top.
What's something you walked away with? You can take away one thing. I know you always got those gems, those Kid Chocolate, you know, little pieces of advice you give. What have you learned from Virgil and, you know, Andre Ward?
Well, you know, Virgil told me something that stuck into my head. He said, you want to be great? Well, I can't be great for you. I can just help you become that. So he's only a tool to my greatness. So if greatness is inside of me, I have to let it come out of me. You know what I mean? But I can't let somebody else be great for me. So, you know, like I said, I took on boxing just as a lifestyle. I work everything around the gym, including my family. And that was one of the hardest things I had to do, because you realize that family's supposed to be first. But if it wasn't for boxing, I probably would never have the family that I got. So, you know, right now it's just taking on as a lifestyle.